Hello, fellows. So I have chosen progressive web apps a while ago, several years ago actually already, and I'm extremely happy to have chosen this. And I want to explain you why. So we're a small company. Most companies I know are small companies. Actually, most companies are small companies and have small team constraints, as I call it, which means that we have the problem that we have limited resources. We have limited amount of budget. We have limited time, even though that might be true to larger companies as well. But matter of fact is, it is especially important for startups and small businesses alike to make sure that you are most efficient in what you do. And the very best way I can imagine is to just have one technology code base for one experience for your clients and align them. So the product idea, the product strategy, and the tech strategy must be aligned. Having a native app and having a web experience or even multiple native experiences is not efficient at all, and it is not great for the user experience, especially not when you have these constraints. So the solution for that is, for me, the progressive web app idea. So it must not be a progressive web app because maybe you don't need offline capabilities, but let's say the most other aspects of PWAs are actually what you would expect from modern apps, web apps or native apps. And when you take into consideration what modern native frameworks can do, like Flutter, like React Native, and then take a look what web technologies can, then you will see that most applications we build as software developers and small companies are better suited for web technologies. And when you have a very specific need for something very, let's say, performance intensive or native capabilities, you still can bridge those with things like capacitor. So you don't have the need to build the actual app around that. So you can have just one experience, you can have just one technology basis, you can have just one application, if you like, to basically fulfill everything and just save time and money. So the best teams are actually teams of two, right? So of course, sometimes we have more work than just two people can do, but the idea behind that is the smaller the teams we have are, and the less teams we have, the more effective we will be focusing on one thing. So that plays as well into the idea of having just one technology instead of several, just one code base instead of several code bases. So that all brings me to the conclusion that PWAs, especially now when they became mature and iOS adopted that stance as well, at least to a degree that we can use it, it is actually a great choice, and I would recommend everyone to consider that technology for the next app. I have written an article about that. Take a look into that. That will be an interesting one for me again. And I would be interested in your experiences. What is your experience with native apps and web apps? Is it actually something you like to do? So having a separate web experience and native experience, or maybe even an Android or iOS experience at the same time? Or do you prefer as well to have just one basis? Do you try it with Flutter or those kind of things? And are you actually happy with that? Because most companies I met so far were, let's say, it was a mixed feeling about that, because you always had the idea of, yeah, Flutter is great, but the web experience is actually meh. Yeah, it is like that. It is not yet there where it should be. Web technologies are, and they will stay. Web technologies are persistent, which means that they won't go anywhere in the next 20 years. I don't know how it's about Flutter. I don't know. React Native, I don't know. So there are always those competitors coming out. There's right now, I forget the one, but there's a new one out as well. It's not so for web technology. So take a look into it. My warm regards there. And I wish you a great day. Have a nice one. See you next time. Goodbye.